you like to build and launch model rockets that you purchase in the store, you don't need to worry too much about rocket stability. And that's because the rockets you buy are already designed to be stable. However, if you want to design your own rocket, you should know a few things about stability. Basically, a rocket that is stable flies straight up, or straight in the general direction in which it is launched. An unstable rocket doesn't. A rocket that isn't stable might fly in a circle or even crash into the ground after it leaves the launch pad. So in this video, I'd like to look at what makes a rocket stable. It's really not all that complicated. Once you understand the basics, it's fairly simple to know what you have to do to make a stable rocket. First, let's take a look at the way a weather vane works. Now bear with me a minute because there might be a few people watching that have never seen a weather vane. A weather vane is a little device that mounts on a swivel on the top of a roof, and it points in the direction that the wind is coming from. In other words, as the wind changes direction, the vane will simply point into the wind all the time, and it allows you to know the wind direction at any given time. Here's a diagram of a simple weather vane. Because of the shape of the vane and the position of the pivot point, it will always turn and point into the wind. Let's take a look at why it does that. Here we have a top-down view, and let's just say the weather vane is pointed like this and a gust of wind comes at it from the side. This creates two opposing forces. The wind that hits the back end of the vane tries to turn the vane to point into the wind. However, the wind that hits the front of the pivot point tries to turn the vane away from the wind, which would be incorrect. So which one of these opposing forces wins the battle? And the answer here should be pretty obvious. Since there is more surface area behind the pivot point than in front of it, the wind that strikes the back of the vane has more leverage than the wind in the front. And so the vane swivels and points into the wind as it should. Here again is the side view. For a weather vane to work, there must always be more surface area to the rear of the pivot point than in front of it. Now let's get back to rockets. A model rocket works on exactly the same principle as a weather vane. In order to make a model rocket stable, you need to have more surface area to the rear of the pivot point than in front of it. That way, the air that is moving past it keeps it pointing up instead of turning it around. Now you're probably thinking that a rocket doesn't have a pivot point because it isn't attached to anything. But that's actually not the case. A free-flying object always rotates around its center of gravity. So to find the pivot point of a rocket, just use a string with a slip knot in it and tie that around the tube of the rocket and position it and so the rocket balances. And you obviously need to do this with the engine installed because that's the way the weight distribution will be when you launch a rocket. Now once you have it balanced, you've identified where the center of gravity is and therefore where it will pivot. And then you need to make sure that you have plenty of surface area or fin area behind or to the rear of the pivot point so it will overpower any surface area that's in front of the pivot point that's working against you. Because your rocket has fins, or at least most of them do, it's a little hard to figure out whether you have enough surface area or not because the fins obviously have different shapes and so forth. So there's a simple test you can do to see if the rocket's stable. This is called the swing test. And you can do this by tying a string around the rocket. Typically you use a slip knot and you want to put this right at the pivot point. So you're going to want to hang the rocket from the string and position it and so it balances. And once you do that, you want to put a piece of tape on the string on the rocket so it stays in place. And then you want to gently swing the rocket around your head. And once the rocket picks up a little speed, it should fly straight. Now this can be a little tricky, especially on smaller rockets. Sometimes you'll get a small rocket that will actually want to fly backwards just because of the weight distribution. But if you take your time and manually start it in the straightforward position, you should be able to get it to fly straight. If you find that the rocket refuses to fly straight, or especially if it tumbles around as it goes through the air, that is a sure sign that it's not stable. If you find that your rocket isn't stable, you probably already know how to fix that based on what I've told you. The most common way is to just add a little bit of weight to the nose cone. That brings the pivot point forward. The other thing you can do is make the fins larger. Now obviously you could also do the reverse of either of those things. For example, you could remove weight from the rear, or you could remove fin area from the front. But typically most rockets don't have any fins in the front unless they're some sort of decorative fins. In that case, you could remove them. That would help. In the case of taking weight off the rear, there again, that's kind of hard unless you want to decrease the power of the engine. So the most common way to fix it is to add some weight to the nose cone or to just make the fins larger. So hopefully you found this helpful. If so, let me know by pressing that like button or leaving me a comment. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.